The Taliban holds its first formal diplomatic engagement since taking over Afghanistan. India's foreign ministry says its ambassador to Qatar held talks with a top Taliban leader Tuesday at the request of the militant group. The two sides are believed to have discussed the safety of Indians left behind in Afghanistan. The envoy also conveyed fears that anti-India militants may use Afghan soil to mount attacks. India has long had concerns over the Taliban because of the group's ties to its arch rival, Pakistan. There was, however, no immediate comment from the Taliban on the talks, which come days after the head of their political office discussed establishing political and economic ties with India. The Taliban is celebrating what they're calling their complete independence as the United States finishes its withdrawal from Afghanistan. Let's take a look.
Celebratory gunfire echoed across Kabul in Tuesday's early hours as the last American troops withdrew from Afghanistan after two decades of war. There were cheers and car horns honking as the last planes left the city in what a Taliban spokesman hailed as, quote, complete independence, according to Al Jazeera. One resident said it was time to rebuild the country.
During these 20 years, the Americans have done a lot of damage to the Afghan state. What will happen to the Afghan state after this? I appeal to all our political leaders, elders, and young people, let's take our matters into our own hands. How long will we remain dependent on foreigners? Let's put our homeland together ourselves.
The last images coming out of Afghanistan ahead of the American withdrawal marked a hasty and humiliating exit for the U.S. and its allies after the Taliban took over Kabul with lightning speed earlier this month. Video footage released by the Taliban on Monday showed its fighters entering the airport after the last troops flew out a minute before midnight. And the U.S. Army shared a ghostly green image of the last U.S. soldier to step aboard a final flight, Major General Chris Donahue, commander of the 82nd Airborne Division. In a statement on Monday, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken vowed to help what he estimated to be the 100 or so Americans still left in Afghanistan.
Now?
And said Washington would hold the new Taliban government accountable.
We engaged with the Taliban during the past few weeks to enable our evacuation operations. Going forward, any engagement with a Taliban-led government in Kabul will be driven by one thing only, our vital national interests.
As U.S. troops departed, they destroyed more than 70 aircraft, dozens of armored vehicles, and disabled air defenses that had thwarted an attempted Islamic State rocket attack the day prior.
U.S. President Joe Biden takes responsibility for the chaotic U.S. evacuations in Afghanistan. Though in his first remarks since that final pullout, Biden again stressed the roles the Afghan military and former President Donald Trump had as well.
By the time I came to office, the Taliban was in its strongest military position since 2001, controlling or contesting nearly half of the country. The previous administration's agreement said that if we stuck to the May 1st deadline that they had signed on to leave by, the Taliban wouldn't attack any American forces. But if we stayed, all bets were off. So we were left with a simple decision: either follow through on the commitment made by the last administration and leave Afghanistan, or say we weren't leaving and commit another tens of thousands more troops going back to war. That was the choice, the real choice, between leaving or escalating. I was not going to extend this forever war, and I was not extending a forever exit. I take responsibility for the decision. Now, some say we should have started mass evacuation sooner. And couldn't this have been done in a more orderly manner? I respectfully disagree. Imagine if we'd begun evacuations in June or July, bringing in thousands of American troops and evacuating more than 120,000 people in the middle of a civil war. There still would have been a rush to the airport.
Biden insists that the evacuation was still an extraordinary success, as 90% of the Americans who wanted to leave were able to do so. He adds that Washington has leverage over the Taliban to ensure that the remaining Americans there can still depart safely.